Right, so hello and welcome to the first official squad leader training in all of Project Reality. Actually, the first time we're doing this stuff. So, since we don't have that many blue four people and we don't have enough runs to... The fuck is that in the truck?
I don't fucking know. Yes, you dumbass.
So, we will have two squad leaders for you today, which will be Obamias and Sinners. So congratulations to those two cunts. If you could step next to me.
Yay!
Defense, and let's go take a trans Humvees and head over there. Good luck, have fun, boys.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Yes, sir! Roger that!
The corner fence. I'm gonna blow him up.
Okay.
Okay.
I got stairs.
You can look
there
to the windows.
Okay.
Britzer.
Yeah, on
the way.
You can go up downstairs.
Grenade! Just go.
Grenade!
Got one.
Stand back. Grenade outside. Fuck, come down.
Medic is coming.
No. They are shooting from the outside with RPGs.
Oh. Got another one there. Medic on the stairs.
Yeah. Stay on your position.
Medic on the stairs.
I got you.
Good job.
Thank you.
Yeah, good.
Don't put smoke. We will not be able to see them. Just stay on your positions and wait.
Shotgun.
I will need the medic. Covering the stairs. Be careful. Is the enemy dead?
I think maybe.
Not maybe. Is it?
I don't know. I died. Just toss him in.
Okay. Be careful. You might throw grenades. Someone cover the stairs always.
I got
medics start to reviving people.
Yo, I need one on stairs to cover.
Okay.
Yo, I need one on stairs to cover.
Just pick me up.
Need one here. One guys. Guys. One on me here, cover the stairs. One, security there. Go.
You,
medic, be careful.
You,
okay, okay, okay.
No, thank you.
Good job.
Bishop, cover northeast.
Continue checking. Continue checking outside.
On the stairs, on the
stairs. Stairs.
Be careful. Don't bunch up like this. Don't bunch up like this.
He's we're done, we're done, we're done.
He's not dead. He's not dead. Throw a grenade downstairs. Throw a grenade downstairs.
He's like, I'm black and white. I don't see shit.
Okay,
nade
wait.
Try to stop me.
Nade in the stairs.
Okay. Nade, be careful.
Thank you, thank you. Spawn it. I'm on the roof. Yeah. I'm gonna be down. Okay, okay. No, no, no. Coming upstairs. Pero bueno. No pasa nada, que es gente novata.
First objective was I was pretty sure what I had to do, so we had to defend the building. It was not that difficult. Everyone held his position, and we made it after all. So.
Yeah, yeah, yo, yo, ya, pues ya has dicho que no subirás.
Ya, ya lo sé. Sí, sí, pero pues lo ha dicho él y digo, pues ya, ya me toca.
Es lo que tiene.
Yeah, I guess it was me. The first round versus the squad that we got wiped, actually, it was pretty good from our side. We were able to get close to the corner building, throwing some nades. I was surprised that almost nobody died from those nades. We threw a lot of them inside, and just were surprised that after trying to push inside by the stairs, there was a breacher lying exactly on top of the stairs with the fucking shotgun and just one shot in us. It took us by surprise. But I guess we wiped like half of the enemy squad, then the one person that was alive almost wiped the rest of the enemy squad, but he was nonetheless killed. But it was a good approach. The things that were bad on our side was probably that the AR was not able to kill almost anybody because almost everyone was inside the corner, so he didn't get good line sight. And also we threw all of our explosives at the entrance and none of them were left to later on help us kill the squad.
Yeah, but if we have to move, we'll move, man.
By the way, get inside the truck and be on the passenger.
Yeah, yeah, stay on the passenger seat, it would be nice.
He's already AFK.
Nice.
Okay.
Okay, we have one guy AFK.
Come on, get inside the truck.
Okay, I'll drive you through your next.
Okay,
we got
the AFK.
Who is
it?
Hold it.
He's dying.
To the last 10. Where was the LATKIT situated here?
They do not have any LATKIT.
Oh. Yeah, my thought is that on most maps that are like that, there might be APCs, so if an APC would come in and people are quite bunched up on the second floor, they could be taken out easily. And also if enemies had a good grenadier or one insurgent was able to sneak up close, they could throw in a nade and kill many people at once, which would render the defense on the second floor quite weak.
Mm-hmm.
The squad lead patrolling around is good to make sure that everything's okay and people are doing the correct job, and just keeping on general overlook on the situation Breacher is doing good checking those like tough to shoot corners because he has a shotgun, MG and Grenadier on roof giving cover is good. Medic in cover is good. But obviously the building is small. If I was a squad leader, I would, if I had more time, like if I was there for more than 2-3 minutes, I would try to find a second building close to there to put my squad in two buildings so they are not as bunched up. Yeah, obviously the floors are dependent on the map, like the rooftop could be bad if there's easy places for snipers to be on higher ground and snipe to people on the rooftop. There's no way to get them revived then, but if there's nothing, then the rooftop is strong because it's the high ground.
Yes.
In the map and so on, and the ground floor could be bad if there's an enemy breacher close by or something like that, that can easily come with the shotgun. And obviously the stairs are easier to defend from a shotgun rush than the ground floor. So that guy Patch, for no reason, he could have run to the medic to not waste a patch. Yeah, still. And since the upper floor is being naded, I would move at least two people to the ground floor, so everyone won't be taken out by one nade. That was good from the medic. He checked around before he dragged. Larger view, I would not put anyone on the roof unless we had a friendly marksman on the squad, because there's all around there's buildings that can see the roof. I would put actually only two or three people on the second floor and have them look to the crossing and both sides of the building, and then I would have four people covering the, or whatever, how many we have left, covering the ground floor, looking at the alleys, and maybe even have one guy be pushed up a bit more to have vision outside of the alleys.
Know everything about their surroundings, how they died, and so on. So just keep this.
Yo, what?
Dude. Keep trying to keep the squad alive by looking. When you press caps lock on the names, if all names are green, then you're. I can see them from here.
For the Lima line, the problem I did is not given a lot of comms, and I didn't check every side. We get attacked from the south side. It was kinda suck because no one was there, and it was like really quick. Just in 1 minute, the whole squad was wiped out.
For the second time went a lot better when we were the one to win. It was mostly because that the AR on the roof did not spot us, we spotted them, and we had a sniper on our side, so he could easily take care of the roof. But we won that mostly because the knights this time were a little bit better, and they killed like almost everybody in the corner. Also, the AR this time was heavy MG that was stationed closer, so he had a better view on the corner and the street, so he could cover us a little bit better.
Is this man using a law to the 84?
Yes.
Disgusting. He should be banned. First, the squad composition. Too many people on the rooftops without the proper... You don't need so many people on the rooftop, especially they only have one fire support role as an AR. He should be the only one on the rooftop. Mm-hmm. The rooftop was also a bad choice. I mean, this particular rooftop, they left the corner building is already covering that side with the upper floor, so they don't need to be in on this upper rooftop because they're overwatching basically the same thing. Yes, they can see a little bit more, but the side that the enemy attacked was more exposed, so they had no overwatch on that side. That would be the southeast east side. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That armored overwatch on the hills didn't overwatch anything. It was completely out of position. Also, I would not leave four people in the Humvees for no particular reason, especially if you're on Overwatch. That second Humvee shouldn't be in the town at all if they're having an Overwatch, because one lad can destroy it, and then you have like two members KIA immediately. You cannot even revive them. They all grouped up on the balcony, which is always a bad idea.
And they also died, that's why.
That's they all died. They should be spread around. If you like one people, one of them should watch the floors, preferably Breacher with a shotgun. One should be on the upper floor and one should be on the balcony, so you have overwatch. So my point is, they focused too many eggs in one basket. Everybody was watching west. The rooftop overwatch was west. The armor overwatch was west. They completely excluded the option that they can be attacked from the other side. So they need more sentries. You know, at least one guy. You know, as a booby trap. You know, uh-huh. If somebody comes by, even if he dies, you know that the enemy is coming from the other side. Nobody noticed the enemies until it was too late, so they got pretty much wiped before they could. And they were spread around. That's also they were too spread around. They couldn't support each other. You know, one element falls, the other elements cannot reinforce, or medics cannot go into the position because you have like two people in one Humvee, two people in the other Humvee. You have three people in one roof. The other guy is on the completely opposite roof, on the other side of the street, and you have like whatever remains in the corner of the building. So I just think they were too spread out, they couldn't support each other, and they focused too much on one side, excluding the option that could be an attack from the other side.
The enemy sniper shoot at these four, and they killed like two AR at the rooftop. I mean, the AR is getting down, and the other is...
That's what I said. You only need one, like... Or maybe two, depending on your kit, if you have like a marksman or a heavy machine gun or sniper, whatever. And one or two people on the rooftops, those people, those are roles that can suppress or kill high distance targets. So like AR's heavy machine gun or a sniper marksman, something like that. You don't need like four people on the rooftops. Yeah, look at this. One Humvee could have killed all this. Like they're going straight down the street, there's no cover. If that Humvee, one of the Humvees were covering this part of the town, you don't need even people. You could just place one of the Humvees covering this entire side. A 50 cal would have eaten three, four guys immediately, and then you have like half of the squad already KIA, so or wounded. Yeah, as you could see, that here second Humvee, if I believe this one, if you go rewind further into the end of the video, you will see that I think that Humvee was somewhere part inside enclosed walls.
Yes,
if I hear. So this was completely, you know, you're wasting a 50 cal, you're wasting a vehicle, and you have no watch. And for this is not the position you want to be in anyway, you know, on this rooftop, because you're cut off from the rest of your squad. And to support you, they need to cross the open street and hook up on the high roof, which is very exposed. So